music, and but you will be able to. So that's brilliant, because you'll be able to hear the wonderful effect that we've got, and that we, I didn't do anything. It was Mark, and it was Mark and my nephew Luke, who's added all sorts of wonderful bits and bobs. And I particularly, my favourite thing that he's added is in Honey Pie, the honky tonk piano, which I think is wonderful. Anyway, so I hope you can all hear me. I won't be able to hear the songs as they happen, but with any luck, we'll be able to next time, and I haven't even talked to Mark about this, next time we'll be able to do it with me hearing the songs and conducting. But anyway, we will play them through to you, all of them, and you will be able to enjoy them and enjoy the wonderful effects. And then we will hear them again, and you can actually sing with them. You can sing with them both times if you like. Okay, so let us start with, let us please start with When I'm 64, shall we? I think you'll be pleased. The result is fantastic from you, the singers, and from Luke and from Mark, both Marks. It's brilliant. And of course, we have to thank Lennon and McCartney, because they had a little bit of a hand in it. Anyway, off we go. The first one, When I'm 64. Certainly did when I heard it, and it's a fantastic piece anyway. Fantastic piece written by Lennon and McCartney. December 1966 it was written, released May 67, And Paul actually wrote it when he was 14. And it's so sweet. And anyway, his manuscript, by the way, sold for $55,000 in 1994. And I think that's cheap at the price, really. What a fantastic thing to have achieved. So I hope you enjoyed that. I would have enjoyed it if I could hear it, but I did enjoy it when I did hear it. And it's, I forgot to say also, it's Ben Parry and Joanna Forbes Lestrange, who also led our singing, who Ben, as well as being in charge of the National Youth Choir, is one that used to be a Swingle singer, so he really knows the style very well. And they both do arrangements of these things. So anyway, splendid. So I'm going to leave Honey Pie to the end, because Honey Pie is, I think, absolutely superb, and you will love it. It's quite difficult, isn't it, Honey Pie? And but I hope you enjoyed doing it. Let's next do Yesterday. Okay, Yesterday, I think I told you the story, but I'll tell it to you again because I so love it. I wanted to know about this second chord. Every bit of that harmony is absolutely superb, but the second chord is particularly inspired. Anything about harmony and music, no reason you should know about harmony, but that's the relative minor, and he goes to the relative minor very, very quickly. Anyway, just so when you listen to it, enjoy the harmony, because it's choice, it's absolutely wonderful. Here we go, here's our version of Yesterday, which you did superbly, thank you. You enjoyed that, because that was, for me, that was an exceptionally good effort of everybody. And what a lovely piece it is. And I think that's one of those songs which will last and last and last, because I don't think it has been surpassed. So third out of our four is Here, There and Everywhere. And the idea is that we play them twice to you. The first time you just sit there and enjoy and hear the effect, and the second time you sing. And it's up to you, of course, but that's the sort of suggestion. So the next one is Here, There and Everywhere, which is just such a moving piece, I think. It was from the album Revolver, written by Paul, and it was one of Paul's favourites of all. And I think, again, the harmony is amazing. They have such a wonderful ear for harmony. And sadly, at the moment, in our schools, less musical theory is being taught. And so fewer people are going to know about harmony. And for me, the knowledge of harmony absolutely transformed my enjoyment. I enjoyed things a lot before I knew about it, but when I knew about harmony and understood it, the more I do understand harmony, the more I absolutely love it. So let's next hear Here, There and Everywhere. Enjoyed that, Here, There and Everywhere. It's a remarkable piece, and I can't remember whether they're entirely my choice, these four. I think they are, but if they're someone else's choice, then they show very good taste. Nikki Chilton has just said in the chat that she's starting to do theory at 37. I think that nobody should be remotely embarrassed about doing music or learning anything late on. Whence comes this idea that you learn when you're at school, at university, then you know everything and off you go and you do it? I know it's not as simple as that anyway, but I really believe that education should be a form of tokens that are spread over all of your time, and you can use them whenever you like. course, we'll need to be at school when we start off. But then as time goes on, we make our own choices. And we should be sensitive to the age at which people make choices. There's a wonderful man called John Holt who wrote about education. And I went to see him in America to see where he lived and meet him. And he just died when I got there. It's such a shame how children learn and how children fail. Brilliant writing. He also wrote a book called Never Too Late. He took up the cello and the flute when he was in his 40s and chronicles what it was like to learn those instruments. And he puts it alongside his, he was a math teacher, he put it alongside his teaching of maths so that he could, or math as he would call it, so that he could understand the process that went on in his mind in learning the cello compared with the processes that went on in people's minds learning maths. And Kathy Tyers started theory at 63, I see in the chat. That's wonderful. Start it. If you want to do it, start it. It is never too late. That's the title of John Holt's book. You may like to get it. Never Too Late. And for the next session, I'll get it out and I'll show you the cover so that you can see and appreciate it. Anyway, so the next one is, Hey Jude. We got Hey Jude and then Honey Pie after that. So let's do Hey Jude.
Hey Jude. Thank you.
Great. Well, I'm sure you enjoyed that. And did you enjoy the, did you get the ending right? Because it goes on about 15 times before you're supposed to join in. While I was not hearing that, I went and looked, and here are the books I was talking about. How Children Fail, How Children Learn, and then the great book, Never Too Late. And when you're 20, it's not too late. When you're 15, it's not too late. When you're 90, it's not too late. And I don't know about you, but when I look at, when I read books I really love, I write little scribbles down the side of them so that I can go back and look at them. And here was when his teacher heard him playing random notes just in any order. And when his teacher heard, he apologized and said, oh no, I'll get back. And the teacher very wisely said, it's fine. That's what it's all about. We're making nice sounds with music. Don't feel you have to be sticking to anyone else's syllabus all the time. Anyway, now, what is absolutely remarkable, I think, about Honey Pie is that it's in the music hall tradition, and it's in the music hall style. It's written in November 1968, and it's a lovely story about an old lover who wants her to rejoin him in England. And it was recorded partly very near to where I was living at the time in Walton-on-Thames. This is in Esher. Anyway, let's hear Honey Pie. And as I said, enjoy the honky-tonk piano, which is added by my nephew Luke. Song, well sung by everybody, excellent arrangement. We were led well in the singing, and I hope you enjoyed the piano, and the pastiche of that is superb. Now, we're just going to go through all five again, and the idea is that either you simply listen to them again or get someone else to come and listen to them because you've now heard how good they are, or you sing them. So let's start straight away with when I'm 64. And as always with singing, don't worry about what you think your voice may sound like. It sounds completely different to everyone else from how it seems to you. Just have fun, okay? Sang as well as on the recordings, it was well done. So fantastic. Next we have Hey Jude. Sing along and love it.
Hey Jude.
Hey, Jude, don't be afraid.
two more to go. Here, There and Everywhere, which was one of Paul's favourites of all, arranged by my brother-in-law, Richard Brett. And here we go. And then after that, we have Honey Pie to finish. So do join in. Here, There and Everywhere. Two more to go. Sorry to tantalise you with the lack of Yesterday. Of course, we must have Yesterday, my favourite of all time. And please remember that you can get a CD of the whole lot, recording of the whole lot, which would be lovely. And also, there's an opportunity, thank you very much, Mark, there's an opportunity to contribute to one of my charities, which is Rodolphus Foundation, which exists to run week-long courses of intense music making for 8 to 15-year-olds, some of them the junior courses, and for 16 to 20-year-olds, the senior courses. And I'm planning some adult ones as well, which would be a weekend plus a Friday night, or possibly plus a Thursday night. So watch this space. But we want, of course, to have everybody, regardless of means, able to come on these courses. So the Rodolphus Foundation raised money for that. So if you would like to contribute, I would be extremely grateful for anything you can give. So let's now hear Yesterday. All My Troubles Seem So Far Away.
I'm not afraid.
Thank you. Right, we're on to the last piece, which is the wonderful Honey Pie with that tremendous arrangement, not done by me, I should say. And by the way, if you want to go independently and find out about those courses, it's important to remember, or indeed put money into the Rodolphus Foundation, thank you very much. It's got an odd spelling, R-O-D-O-L-F-U-S. R-O-D-O-L-F-U-S. Anyway, let's finish with Honey Pie, and then we have another session, don't we? So I'll be seeing you again, and it'll be great. Okay, thank you, Mark, and everyone that has made this possible, because it's been great to be with you. It's lovely to sort of feel that I'm with you again, even though there's no interaction. And look forward to the next time. Here we go, our final thing, Honey Pie. Tantalizing to see you all quoting the words shaboo and badoo and stuff and not be able to hear them. But anyway, I did hear them before several times and I loved it. So well done, everybody, and goodbye.